really awesome that these days you no longer need a $30,000 mixing console and half a room of outboard effects just to mix some music. With just a laptop and a decent pair of headphones, you can start making amazing music. But with just a mouse, you also lose some of the creature comforts that hardware allows. For example, moving multiple faders and knobs at once. That's where something like a control surface can come in handy. Basically, these allow you to control parameters within your DAW. Unlike an analog mixing console, a control surface does not process any audio. They send and receive MIDI signals, and MIDI signals are just little bits of data that say this knob is pressed or this fader is at that position. I'd always been on the lookout for some kind of control surface that I could use to control FL Studio to do some mixing. Now, as some of you might know, FL Studio hasn't always had the best support for external hardware. It looked like the only option was to use a control surface that supports MCU, so that's the Mackie Control Universal standard. But even then, I found a lot of information online that mentioned that support for MCU extenders was pretty poor in FL Studio. About 2 years ago, there was some good news. FL Studio introduced a new feature called MIDI scripting. This allows hardware manufacturers and the community in general to write custom implementations for external MIDI hardware. This gave me more faith that a control surface could actually work great with FL Studio. So then I ended up purchasing a Behringer X-Touch and 2 extenders. That gave me 24 motorized faders that I can use for my mixing position, and it also works with the MCU protocol. When I got started with these units, it quickly became obvious to me that the existing script for MCU provided by ImageLine did not perform all that great. Actually, it was worse than expected. The second extender showed the same faders as the main unit. Banking did not work properly, it was also not very stable, and sometimes the X-Touch just stopped working out of nowhere. The meters also showed incorrect values. I was of course hoping that these issues would get solved by the community.
Nope.
But after some time with no fixes, I just decided to give it a go myself. I have quite some experience with software development, but the FL Studio MIDI scripting uses Python and MIDI, which are two things that I had never used before. So instead of creating an all new script, I decided to just take the existing implementation by ImageLine and started editing that one. Sorry for the guys that originally programmed this, but the existing code was pretty horrible. Everything in one file, quite unreadable, no comments, functions being called that didn't even exist. Sometimes it was also really hard to figure out what certain pieces of the code were actually trying to achieve. I've been steadily rewriting a lot of the code. It does take some time to do so properly, so it's still a work in progress right now. However, I did get a lot of things working already. There's support for multiple extenders right now, colored scribble strips. There's a lot of bug fixes and improvements as well. I've definitely gotten it to a point right now where it's very usable. However, there still are some things lacking. I still need to rewrite a lot of the existing code, and I also still want to add some extra functionality, for example, being able to control effect plugins. Because I have a lot of things on my plate, the only time when I can really work on this is when I'm on a holiday. So if there are any other FL Studio users that have an X-Touch, feel free to join me in the development of this script. So after using the X-Touch for a while, is it worth having? Well, it's great to use a controller, it feels more natural moving faders than just using your mouse. But it's not like you can stop using a mouse when you're using this controller, at least not right now. You still need to use a mouse for some plugins and stuff like that. It's definitely one of those things that are rather nice to have, and I actually don't know if I would purchase it again. I'd perfectly be able to get by with just a mouse and a keyboard as well, but I must admit that it does speed up your workflow. I also feel like you can listen more to the music instead of focusing on your screen and your mouse. Let me know in the comments whether you think a control surface would be something that is helpful to you or not. As for the quality of the hardware itself, it's not bad, but the motorized faders can be a bit clattery and jittery when they're moving. The buttons on the master section seem to have different functionality in every DAW. There's an overlay for every DAW included in the box, but of course not for FL Studio. So right now I just have some stickers with the names of the functionalities next to the buttons. I do sometimes have issues when recording audio as well. When I'm using the X-Touch and it's recording, then it might just suddenly stop. I'm not quite sure yet if this is because of the hardware or FL Studio itself. Anyway, other than that, I can't really complain. The build quality is pretty decent. For anyone interested, I'll be leaving a link to my script in the description of this video. I made it open source, so anyone can use it for free. Wow. Just make sure you're using the latest version of FL Studio. Alright, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, definitely give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing so you don't miss any of the upcoming videos. Also check out some of my other videos, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.